What are the applications of turbidimetry and nephelometry? First, quantitative analysis. Gelatinous or very small size particles are difficult to filter and are so difficult to estimate. Such precipitate can be converted into ideal solutions or suspensions and then can be easily estimated by either nephelometry or turbidimetry. The amount of sulfur present in the coal, oil, rubber, plastic, and several organic materials can be determined. That material which contains sulfur is heated at very high temperature, so that sulfur present is oxidized to corresponding sulfate. This is then treated with barium chloride, so that suspension of barium sulfate is obtained. This suspension is then subjected to nephelometry or turbidimetry. Water, which is required in power plant, nuclear reactor, and steam generating plant like boilers, must be free from any of the suspended particles. That testing can be done by nephelometry or turbidimetry. If no response from the instrument, it means water is free from suspended impurities. Air is continuously monitored for dust and other particulate matters using these two methods. Determination of molecular weight of macromolecules, that is polymers. Polymers have the property of scattering the light. The turbidity of the solution is related with molecular weight of the polymer. Turbidity tau is equals to H into concentration C into molecular weight, where H is a constant depending on polymer and medium. Turbidimetric titrations. In this case, the solution of sulfate is taken in cuvette, and after each addition of the titrant, that is barium chloride, the precipitate formation takes place. This precipitate formation goes on increasing till all the sulfate ions are precipitated, and so the turbidence goes on increasing and is maximum at the equivalence point. After that, it remains constant. The phenomena is used in sewage work. It is used in pharmaceutical industries and petroleum refineries. This is used in pulp and paper manufacturing. The phenomena is applied in determination of suspended particles in liquid found in nature. If you like this video, please click on the like button and also subscribe to my channel.